Or the liquid match to end, but then surprise, we're into the pistol. So, Keedstar's going to be starting onto the CC side. Freakazoid going to be the first to push, but Steel going to find the frag. Flash is coming in, that's two frags for Steel. Make that three. Bolt's getting Shroud after Shroud trades onto Steel. So, all of a sudden, only nothing is remaining with the bomb down as well. He has no choice but to push this, and he will be facing multiple guns. Nade's coming in as well, but Fallen will find a frag.
And it looked like one of the Cloud9 players actually didn't get blind by the flash and just missed maybe 10 bullets from the back there. And considering Steel managed to get another kill after that one, it's just a big mistake from Cloud9 there. They will, however, go for the force by now, and they have three Molotovs, so I'm guessing they have something planned here.
Fingers crossed. It could be the fast push. Again, I always refer to the old Mike SMG lineup that had MSL and other people. They had a really nice execute onto the B bomb site with running Molotovs to the barrels and other places. And it could be a slow setup, but we'll see if they get spotted by some of these players again. Steel is in position to find out some info for his team. Indeed, info he will find. So, they still got these three Molotovs. Shroud starting to get tagged down, so it's time to execute Cloud9. Let's see what you've got. Still two players over towards the A site for Keed. Waiting, waiting, waiting. Our Cloud9. No flanks coming in from the CTs, however. And they're positioning themselves to go in backwards, it seems, with this flashbang from Freakazoid. But is it ever going to come? Indeed. They're just around the corner now, going for the smoke plant as well, which they should just about get, actually. Sean Gare's getting the bomb down for his team. And they're still holding two Molotovs. Oh, they're going for the... to try and stop the defusers from coming in. So they've only got one Molotov left, and Sean Gares is against five, so this is not going to work out for him. He may not even get a chance. They're putting a smoke on onto the bomb just in case. So it was a nice idea, but it didn't get them any kills.
Yeah, the biggest flaw with that idea is that it's very likely that the CTs will have a smoke, which means they can just smoke the bomb, and there's nothing you can do about it. So kind of a funky strat there from Cloud9, but it's interesting to see them trying something new.
Yep.
A very, very good setup from Keystars. Just playing back. That's exactly how you should defend the B site versus a force buy. Just never push towards Monster or Sewers. Just play that defensive. It's so much better.
Okay, so Cloud9 with numbers heading through the connector area might give them an opportunity to pinch Sue, although there's no lurker towards B. And indeed, they're going to go up towards A. Through the toilets, maybe. We'll have to see. Again, Keedstar's playing the sights. They're not going to overextend. So they will be defending in the numbers. There's initial smokes coming down to flush out the checkpoint. No pun intended.
And a full eco here with only one smoke. So just looking to get some kills, maybe the plan.
Okay, well, one person spotted. And ZQK may see others coming. That's three. Going in their direction that they would have spotted now. That's three frags they found. Two more soon to come as well. That FAMAS getting in lots of work.
Yeah, flawless round there from Keedstar. So they will be able to build up a small bank. However, they have three FAMASes, one scout and one P90. Question is, will they upgrade? And it seems like they're just going to stick with these weapons for now. The P90 is actually quite good on overpass. We have seen Flusha use it. Even though he can afford an M4, he actually opted to go for the P90.
Alright, so, Cloud9 on the buy, Shroud finding the first frag, Skadoodle on the AWP, still a bunch of nades here for Cloud9 and that man advantage to see how they can use it, and if Keedstars will turn up the aggression, Bolt's moving forwards towards the toilets area a little bit. Oh, sorry, he's on B, so I guess he's in the sewers, excuse me. But the A site plays, in fact, are playing quite deep. Looks like they're going to want to play the rotation game and retake with numbers, as opposed to being isolated further up the map. Cloud9 seem to be keen on A at the moment. Bomb still in a passive position with support towards the playground area. Starting to head towards long now. So, no lurkers for Cloud9. Just going to commit here to A. And Keedstars are starting to maybe get a rotation from Bolts. He's just having a look through the sewer area while Keedstars will have three people ready and waiting on the A site. There's a blind ZQK. He would have seen the player in long. See if Cloud9 can get a plant with the smokes. Fur gonna get a Molotov kill. And there is a bit of a gap actually. Fallen running through the smoke, but Skadoodle will be covering, getting multiple frags. Two frags for him, two frags for Shroud. And that is keyed on their second bite.
Just excellent mid-round calling there from Sharon Garris. You get the entry kill, you fall back, you play together, you go for the execute afterwards. Three people long, two people toilets, maybe a small detail. The bomb should go like toilets because you can rotate it back then, but still a very, very good round there from Cloud9.
Alright, so super successful round for Cloud9, but that's going to cause the double AWPs for Keyed Stars, bringing out all the guns quite literally in response to Cloud9's first score on the board. Three people in the B bomb site for Keyed at the moment, with only one player, that's ZGK, just going in to find some information, still choosing to play passively, playing from the sites, are the Brazilian team. We'll see if their formation changes as this half continues. ZQK is holding a line onto Long. He's got to look out for this boost, however. In fact, he's moved away just as the boost comes in from Cloud9. So, C9 with Sean Gares just in the toilets area with the rest of his team in Long. But when will they be spotted by the Keyed Stars? They don't really have anybody watching the angle. And look how close the T's are. They're going to find Keyed completely unprepared for this, holding nades out with no one covering Long at all. Two fast frags for Cloud9. Bomb goes down as well. Smoke's all over the place. And this round may already be over.
Yeah, Keyed Stars needs to save. And I'm very surprised that Keyed Stars didn't try to regain control of Long. Sure, they had a guy jumping there in the beginning, but that guy was forced back due to the AWP from Cloud9. But what you won't usually see from teams is that they pop flash for another teammate and just try to regain control of Long, at least try to gain some information, because you can't really let four players walk up Long on you like that.
I'm not sure if the CT's even spotted the Long guys. I think he started moving to toilets just before they started peeking.
In that case, it must be some kind of miscommunication for Keyed Stars.
ZQK was watching it, and before they... I don't know if they peeked the side first, but when they started jumping up, he was already towards the toilets area, and no one seemed to be covering it, and they had nades out towards the toilets and just went down for free. And that's going to put them on the fourth spy with the guns they saved in the previous round. Fallen going for the Mag 7. Now you can see the formation changing for Keyed Stars with some aggression here, but Cloud9 just going to walk straight through and nothing. We'll find a frag onto Bolts in the barrel area. Very important frag there. Shroud taking down Fur in the balcony as well, so Keyed Stars look like they're headed towards the eco. No frags yet. Only Shroud and Nothing taking some damage on the entries. But again, another round in favor of Cloud9 here. And this is a map they've been practicing hard recently. They were practicing this a lot in preparation for Virtus Pro at Gfinity. So they will be well versed on it.
Yeah, very impressive stuff here from Cloud9. And I like the way they're playing different rounds every single round. In the sense that now they went for a B execute the round before that. They went for a long execute, and the round before that, they just did a default, which ended in an A execute. So it's very nice to see that Cloud9 is doing a lot of different things, which makes it hard for Keyed to make a read on them. And that round, just a simple B push, just getting three entry kills right away.
When C9 recently came to London, they had a boot camp evening in our offices here in our gaming room, and I sat behind them watching them practice things and executes on this map, and there are more executes to come, that's for sure. So, only a Mag 7 really surviving from the previous rounds. We'll see how Fallen chooses to use it. But we're going to have some aggression from Keyed Stars down long, down short as well. Flash is coming in, Skadoodle going to go for the peak there. Will he find anything? That Mag 7 getting in close, finding one frag. ZQK finding the second one onto Freakazoid, well, trades for both sides. But Keyed have to be happy with how things have gone so far. Now, there are three T's all around Skadoodle's body there. They do not want Keyed picking up these weapons. Maybe they can find some way of disposing them, but there are so many angles for them to cover at the same time. You can see where Fur is already in the T entrance to Connector. So they're going to have to be very careful. And Sean, I think he just threw the AWP over the wall, actually. Very smart stuff. And I think the other gun was disposed of as well. Timing still not going to find a frag onto Nothing there. So 3 versus 2. Keyed have some information. Bolts will go for the rotate. And Fur will go for the flank. Looking for the guns, but the guns have been rid of. And that's Smart play there by C9. Only the Mag 7 to find. So Bolts had the potential to do something, but he got taken out pretty quickly by Shroud. Oh, Fer could get two here, they're almost lining up for him, but Sean will spin around and shoot him straight in the face. That was unfortunate. For a split second, they were just lined up there for the bowling ball, but the bowling ball never came.
Yeah, it would have been better for him there if he had a 5-7, I guess. Still, two kills is okay. Maybe they wanted more, considering they did save that Mag 7. Let's see if they try to go aggressive here on long. Only having one guy there. Three players towards A, though, for Kid Stars.
Yeah, they've got the buyout once again. AWP and quite reasonable nades as well. That consecutive loss bonus kicking in. So that's going to be a nice flashbang. That was a HE. That would have been astonishing. But Cloud9 get the first frag regardless. And they've taken the site relatively easily here. Fer has a small opportunity, but he can't find the angle through the corner of the smoke. Two plays left for Kid Stars, and this is looking like a disaster now. Cloud9 already with four rounds on the board. And Kid are definitely headed towards Zico this time. Just $200 on these two players. They need to hold on to these weapons if they can.
And once again, a very good call there from Cloud9 doing the fast monster push. Because if you notice that the Cetus doesn't smoke monster right away, or if the Cetus doesn't have someone who peeks deep into monster, you can easily punish that by walking four people out right away. Because as soon as you get to the other end of the tunnel, you can just run out and you gain so much ground so fast, it's almost impossible for the Cetus to stop you.
Okay, so I believe Keed lost to Flipside earlier with Hiko top fragging and Simple bottom fragging. So this is a match that Keed Stars will definitely need to win. Cloud9 though, five rounds on the board of a possible eight so far. Definitely look good going forward. So Keed Stars, again, they're just saving just enough weapons to get these force fires out, but they're still losing the rounds. Sean, not having his gun prepared, but still manages to find a frag, surviving with 11 HP, so a bit of a lucky one for him, but that's going to make the difference here for Cloud9. Nice flash coming out. It's going to force their CTs away. So Cloud9 will continue to advance and take map control. Again, they've got no lurkers towards the B bomb site. I'm wondering if Keed will start to get aggressive here in these coming rounds, because if they can find out this information, it could get them back onto the scoreboard. Could have a spray down here from ZQK. Finds a second player, but he's going to move back and survive rather than be traded. But again, Sean only has 11 HP. And there he goes. 3 versus 3 now. And there's still one CT over towards the bomb site, as all the A players are towards A. Forty seconds left on the clock here, so the body bags definitely going to continue. Freakazoid with a nice snap onto Bolts there. Early advantage. ZQK evening things up, but his position is known now. Only a flashbang left for Cloud9. And the other player is unidentified. Finally, the flank is coming in, but is it going to come in time? ZQK goes down, fallen in position, takes down the bomb. Now he's got AWP versus AWP. Skadoodle with a jumping peek, goes for the frag. Tags the leg, fallen down 17 HP. No pot shots. He doesn't know where the bomb is planted just yet. Skadoodle switched out to the M4. He'll know he tagged him. He'll know he only requires one bullet. Molly coming into the... I was going to say bank area, but he doesn't know if Skadoodle is in the bank, on the truck, on the other side where the bomb's planted. He essentially Molotov'd himself off the bomb for a while he's looking for the frag. But an easy frag for Skadoodle in the end.
And once again, a very simple round there from Cloud9. Just great mid-round decisions after they get the frag. Usually you can see a lot of teams actually commit to a site as soon as they get that entry kill. However, Cloud9 is just playing super passive, just playing very disciplined, waiting to see if Kid will do any aggressions. And if they don't, they just push forward to the A site and do a simple execute.
So, Kid Stars going to get some pistols out and the scout onto ZQK. We've got a double peek coming into connect here, but Sean is just waiting, giving himself that 1 versus 1 with maximum coverage from both the walls. There's a first frag. Fallen will go down soon afterwards. So standard anti-eco play here. Still no aggression from Keystar. Still the remaining players, like in B, for example, not going for any push. It's going to hold the side of Monster, try and find themselves some cheap frags. You might see more movement from the CTs now that the numbers are limited. Indeed, the flank is finally coming in, but it's all too late here for Keystar as Cloud9 move up long towards the A site. Nothing holding the flank as well. Just outside the connector area, where ZQK is stuck between a rock and a hard place. He will announce his scout as nothing takes down bolts coming out of connector. So ZQK should be going down soon as well. Steel disappears after taking down Sean. ZQK is stuck between the flank and the plays on the site. He heads towards the site. Skidoodle gets tagged. Freakazoid comes in to make the save, and Skidoodle will survive with 10 HP.
And it's so hard for Kid to make any good decisions at this point, because Cloud9 has done the fast B push. They have also done the fast long push, which means Kidstars are probably thinking, okay, we need a deep peek towards Monster. We also need to be aggressive on A to stop the fast A push. And you can't do both things at once, so it's very, very hard position here for Kid.
It is indeed. And C9 have yet more executes that they haven't even shown yet. Four-round advantage now, and this T-side is looking monstrous for Cloud9, but they will have to defend on their CT side, but Keed will need more rounds on the board. So, double AWPs coming out again for Keedstars. The nades are limited now. They started with some aggressive positions towards A, but they're starting to move back. Now, Cloud9 finally have a lurker that is nothing towards the B bomb site, which will stop any funny business from Keed for the moment. The bomb is headed over towards the B-bomb site now, as Sean becomes the lurker towards A, keeping people busy as the creep starts. Looking for an opportunity, and that barrel player may be the distraction to get bolts to frag. He gets traded in by Freakazoid, and here it comes. We've got the split now from Short and from Monster. Freakazoid looking for the barrel pick, but Skidoodle gets there first. Sean Guerra is going to follow up on Fur very quickly indeed. 4 versus 2. ZQK holding an angle towards the bomb site. It's a 2-AWP retake versus 4 players. One has gone down. Oh, there was a pot shot to be had there when he saw that nade coming up, but he waits for the peek, doesn't find the frag. And I don't know how much more there is for Keedstars to do here.
Yeah, once again, they have to save. They will, however, save double AWP, which is something, I guess. But the way Cloud9 is playing now, they're just completely outplaying Keed. Keed were up 3-0, and Cloud9 is going to lead 8-3 after this round. And as I said earlier, it's very hard for Keed to really do anything at this point. I feel like they have to be aggressive, though. Even though they're getting out-aimed, which means it's quite hard to be aggressive. They still need to be aggressive because they're playing way too passive now. They're just playing, as we saw, for example, the guy defending Monster. He got one kill and then immediately traded by Freakazoid.
Yeah, and here we go. We're going to have some early aggression here. We're going to have some self-pop flashes for Fallen to go for the peak. But there's going to be no engagement here. We've got Sean in connector. The rest of the team is towards the B bomb site. ZQK goes for a late peak. Through Monster, Skidoodle already in waiting here. We've got a player caught in connector as well. Sean on the chase, Fallen running for dear life. Push comes in onto the B bomb site. Steel finding the first frag. Steel can't find the second one. Shroud will survive with 50 HP. And Cloud9, that should be a nade over towards the barrel area. Indeed, it will, but it's not going to make any. Not going to land anywhere. Cloud9 now just slowing things down. They are dictating the pace of these rounds. And they have a man advantage. Again, Sean just lurking. And look at Keed. They've got one player holding the A site from toilets looking towards long, leaving only two players for Keed towards B with two choke points to try and manage. Fallen finding a frag onto nothing, so that's a good start. But they will need more. They haven't seen the bomb. They don't know if how many players he has behind him. So they're still going to have stuck towards the A site until they have some identification as to what exactly is going on. Indeed, the rotation is coming in towards A, but Wolf hear them. They're running all the way down short. And I think we're going to... He must have the sound cues. He's starting to move. Bolts is sprinting for it, but the A site's already been lost. We'll hold on to long for now. Fallen with a frag on to Shroud as well. They could do this. 1 versus 3. All of a sudden, 10 seconds for Skidoodle to try and do something. And he is going to go down as well. So Keedstars make it happen somehow.
Yeah, nice try there from Cloud9, though. I think they messed up the boost a bit when they tried to peek the barrels on the B site, which gave Fallen a bit of extra time to make that peek, getting that entry kill. But still, they got two frags, which means if they win this round, they will reset Keed's economy. And they're already up 8-4, which means they're going to have a lead going into the second half anyway.
Okay, so we had Fur with a very fast push into connector, but he came straight back out again. And there's a challenge now, three monster, which will be won by the T's with the trades. Trades coming in both ways though. Fallen pushes short as monster is lost. He gets one player down, but Freakazoid will come in to trade once more. And it's advantage C9 as they have the man advantage for a few seconds. Shroud getting eliminated by the nade of Fern. Now ZQK looking from the upper position. Those stairs are quite useful for different angles on those peaks. You know, Adren from Team Liquid uses those stairs as well with the AWP. So Fern on the site. He is one of the kits as well. ZQK needs to try and hold things down there with the AWP. Fern's running out of time to go for defuse here. We've got the Molotovs on the site once again. And HE's bouncing off the pillar. That's really nice stuff from Cloud9. But it's not going to get them the round. Or will it? There isn't enough time for Fern, despite having a kit.
Yeah, awesome play there from Cloud9 using the Molotovs and HE's to just deny the defuse. And just once again, walking out four people through Monster, and I'm kind of surprised that Keedstars keep taking these positions where you get one kill, you have nowhere to escape, so you will be traded immediately. Usually you want to stand a bit back in the beginning of the round, stand towards the Cedar Water, because from there you can just take a peek, fall back, wait for the rotation, and then just try to... You can even let the terrorist plant. We see Fnatic flush are playing that position perfectly, where he lets them plant and just wait for the rotation and just keep all five players alive and then just win the retake.
Right, so Fallen trying to spot with the scouts. And he will spot some information. ZQK with the P250 to get a frag onto nothing, but of course the trade coming in from the AKs. So, 4 versus 4 here. Minutes on the clock for Cloud9 to play with. And Keedstar still only have the scout, a CZ, a P2000, and a USB. Scout spot some information, we'll get out of there. They'll play the numbers game with the CTs. If they can. Again, they have limited equipment. That nade will be avoided by steel. Have a bit of a... That's really nice there. Basically gets a pre-fire in based on the shadow coming through. And that's a dink onto Shroud. Left with 37 HP. Fallen looking to follow up on these players now. Taking down Freakazoid. Can he get any more? Steel in the middle of the smoke. He's looking to try and punish a plant maybe. But Sean will find him before he can do exactly that. Sean goes for the plant now. Shroud going down. Just Sean versus 3. Many angles for him to hold. There's the first one. Bolt and Fallen. Both heavily tagged. Sean can do this. But he is tagged as well. Now it's him versus the scout, which is reloading. He must have heard the reload there. He went for a fake flash with the gun. And he will clutch the round for his team.
A great decision making there from Sean. Just going for the challenges. Because he knows it's very unlikely that they will have Kevlar. So... falling back there only risks him getting flashed or something, so it's just best to just go for the peaks right away.
So, 4 rounds on the board for Keedstars. Won't be an easy second half, whether it's 4 or 5, but they will hope it's 5. Only one kit on the CT side, that's going to be on Fur. Got the initial nades coming in to try and slow things down there. P90 putting in work, that's the bomb scene in the area, the sewer area near the connector. That doesn't mean that the bomb can still rotate to either site, but look at the aggression from Keedstars up above. They've got one person almost in T-spawn, one person outside connector. The third will rotate over towards the B-bomb site, and Keedstars are very well set up now to take this round. But they will still need the frags to go their way, and Skidoodle has taken down Bolts. The flank starting to move forward from Fern. He's going to have to get there faster as another frag goes the way of Cloud9. Fallen, finding nothing. ZQK to take down Shroud as well. 3 versus 2. And the flank coming in the monster area, bombs down on site. See, Fur's just creeping as ZQK tries to pressure connector. But he'll have limited bullets with the silence turn 4. And now Fur's flank gets flanked by Sean Gare's free monster. Only down to Skidoodle now. 9 HP versus 6 HP. Next hit wins. Bomb gets planted. Skidoodle has no idea where the last CT may be. Will he hear a sound cue from ZQK? That's going to be the frag, and it will be 5 rounds to 10, Cloud9 in the lead.
A very good half here from Cloud9. Cloud9 losing the pistol round, they were down 3-0, managing to win 10-5. And it's going to be very, very tough for Keedstars to come back into this game. They basically have to win the pistol round, and after that, just keep resetting Cloud9's economy, force them to a lot of ecos. Because I have a very hard time seeing them playing as well as Cloud9 did here. They just played this half perfectly. Almost in every single way. They just had a lot of different executes. Did go for the default for the fast long play. Did a lot of fast B plays. if they got the entry kill, they just fell back, just played it safe, see if there were any aggression. So textbook stuff here from Cloud9.
New Cloud9 continuing to impress this time here in Montreal. Next week it'll be in Valencia. And I know that they're going to be living out of a suitcase for about a month and a half. So we're going to see them all over the place. So second pistol round now. C9 starting on the favored CT side. So in response to Jordan throwing nades over the train yard, they have made the train start with a certain timing. But for now, it's going to be pistols. One person down for either side. We're seeing rotations coming in from the Cloud9 team as Keedstars battle for the other half of the site. Nothing is hiding underneath the bomb area in the water, waiting for his teammates to rotate. Maybe he'll try a sneaky smoke push or see if what he can find on the edge. There's one frag, instantly traded though. Took a bit of damage from a teammate as well. Two versus two now. Sean Gares with only 6 HP. Needs to find the frags and find them fast. Skidoo running distraction. Sean finds a frag. We'll be down to Steel, who survives with 99. And Keedstars win a very important round.
Yeah, that was a must win for Keed. And I wonder if Cloud9 will go for the Force Buy. They're up 10-6 as CT. And they're going to go for the Force Buy. I mean, CT Overpass is probably the easiest map to win the second round Force Buy as CT. But seeing that they were up 10-5, I would actually just opt to go for the simple Peach 50 Buy and just try to pressure the economy. Double scout on Skadul and Sean.
Let's see if they try to go for the double tags together, or if they will spread out and spot elsewhere. There's a fast rotation from the CTs. They know it's going to be B, and the other two are coming through A to try and join their teammates. Keedstars being a bit tentative at the moment. Haven't really done that much damage apart from onto Freakazoid. Bunch of smokes out, and now the entire C9 team is here. Up above is not smoked. There's nobody in sewer to throw the smoke there. And Skidoo is just taking pot shots across all of these Keedstars players. Three versus three now. Nothing goes down, but Steel and Fur heavily tagged. Bolt's not doing well either. That's the bomb down. Skidoo finding another one. He found himself four frags from the balcony area and then pushing onto the site itself. That was a disaster for Keedstars.
Yeah, and also very cool defense there from Cloud9. And that's exactly what I'm talking about. That's how you want to defend B on overpass. You just want to fall back into the city water, keep the terrorists in the T water outside of Monster. And as you could see there, they were just stuck there. They couldn't get up. They had a scout on the high ramp on the balcony, and there's nothing you can do.
So Keed9 reduced to the Keedstars reduced to the Tech Nines. That's what I was trying to say. And the P250, one flash onto Fur. This round's going to be about economical damage to the C2 economy and about trying to plant the bomb. Now you can see Cloud9 have moved to passive positions here, of course, on the anti-eco situation. Sean, look at the timing, just looks away as somebody crosses long. I don't know if he heard a sound cue. I don't think he did, as he's checking the left, but there is someone to the right, and that's Bolts. Flash coming in now, and Bolts, no armor, is going to go down to only the one shot there from Sean Gares. Trying to do some more damage, but Skidoo nothing is stealing all the kills. Only Steel left, bomb on the floor. And this will be a fail for Keedstars.
Yeah, Steel with a flank doesn't manage to get another kill. So only one frag there from Keedstars, which means, of course, that Cloud9 will be able to build up a small bank. And they just need to buy every round, Keedstars. They can't eco, because that means Cloud9 will build a bank, and as I said earlier, they need to force Cloud9 to a lot of ecos if they want to come back into this game.
Yeah, Keedstars will lament that second round in this half, where they had no answers to the situation, and here they are now in an even more difficult one. Three Galores, one AK, and just a Tech9 onto Bolts. If he can get close, though, he can get in some work, but look at this. This is a slaughterhouse, and it's advantage CTs, only Fur remaining. Gets one more frag, but the nade from Shroud will finish things off here. Three plays down for Cloud9, actually. That's important. But Cloud9 are now on 13 rounds.
Yeah, and Keed still must go for a very, very low buy. We're going to see a Tech9, and they must buy here. They cannot go for the eco. They're actually opting to go for the eco here. I mean, they have an opening to actually force Cloud9 to an eco if they win this one. So they really should have gone for the force buy here. Considering they're down 6-13 as T on overpass.
Yeah, the long-term implications maybe not being considered here by the Brazilian side. Skidoo with the opening entry onto Fern. He will move into a more passive position. more support from his teammates. Nice dink onto Freakazoid, but he will go for the full spray with the P90. Steel going down. Only three players remaining for Keemstars. That could be an entry to try and get a plant, but the remaining two T's are separated. That's the bomb down miles away from Bolt. Full rotation coming in. Every second that passes now is just another signature on the death sentence for Bolt. Takes one down with him. And now the buy comes out from the Brazil side.
And we see a full set of smokes, two Molotovs. Keemstars is a team that's known for doing a really cool execute. Let's see if they can do an execute here. Usually see the early exit towards the B side, but the bomb is going towards A, so probably going to be a default opening into an A push.
Shroud AWPing with Skadoodle on the AK. Shroud sitting on $8,000+. I think it was a timing pick. Indeed it was. You can see them exchanging the weapons there. So give me that back, you fraud. Take this AK instead. So, now this is something we didn't see from Keed, where they've been forced basically to have a slow approach to A, as they have no idea what's safe, what's not, especially after the pick from Skadoodle in the previous round. Sean Gares will smoke himself off, but the bomb was almost on the flank there, but that might have turned out into a disaster. So, Keemstars more or less in control of Connector for now, but they need to be scared of the flank coming up a bit later. You can see Steel in the water there, but can they cross? Steel, Sean in his position could make things difficult for the T's later on. Skadoodle spots one in long, and the bomb is soon to join. Sean goes down in Connector, so that's the options open for Keed once more. 4 versus 4 now, with 30 seconds left on the clock. Bomb moving away from long into toilet, so I think it's going to go towards B. ZQK's heading down into connector to ensure safe passage. And in fact, the CT seems to be rotating towards the B bomb site. Steel now looking for an entry. Going to be able to get past the Molotov before before the payload goes off. Takes down Triad, the rotation comes back from the CT. 3 versus 3, fallen, only 4 HP, goes down immediately to Freakazoid. And you've got to watch out because Skadoodle's on the warpath with that AWP. We have two teammates for support. Nothing goes down to Steel. 2 versus 1 now as Skadoodle gets the AWP rattling off. So ZQK on short versus 2. Goes for the fast push. Takes down Skadoodle. He's got flames to contend with. And Freakazoid will bait and punish. Match point to Cloud9.
A great decision making there from Freakazoid. Realizing it's very likely that the terrorist is going to expect the full defuse because of the Molotov. So he just aims at the Molotov and... As we saw, there was a terrorist pushing through the Molotov. He gets the kill and is able to defuse. And 9 rounds now in a row for Keemstars if they want to force this game into overtime.
Alright, so... Every round is a must-win here for Keemstars. Sean going for the early pick. Only sees one player, but there are indeed two. Are we going to see a push for this smoke? No, we won't. We can't afford to take those risks. And but look at the support already in the sewer. Two players there for Cloud9 just in case they're needed. Sean finding a smoke. Sorry, a shot. I think that was through the smoke. I didn't actually see it. Either way, it's early advantage for Keemstars here. I mean, for Cloud9. Keemstars with some positioning towards the toilet area. But again, they're at the man disadvantage. Bomb left in a passive position just outside of T spawn. Slowly moving to join teammates who continue their advance towards A.
And three players very deep on the B side, so they actually have an opening here to push A.
Sean reloading in open play. Gets taken down by Bolts. But the numbers are still in their favour. This is one of the better maps to have four people on the CT side because of the speed of the rotations. Nice timing on that Molotov there. We'll slow down the push here from Keemstars. Skadoodle taking down Bolts as well. 4 versus 2 now. And the days for Keemstars here look numbered. And that's going to be 0-2 for Keemstars in their first two matches. Cloud9 taking it 16-6.
Yeah, that was...